Hello, Rubik's Cubers, and welcome to step 6 of the Coffer No Algorithm Method of solving the Rubik's Cube. We're going to demonstrate in this video how to orient the final corner pieces. And you'll have anything from 0 to a maximum of 5 corner pieces that will need to be oriented in this step. But in our prior steps, we got through all of our layers. Everything should be, all the corners should be in their correct locations. And we should have anywhere, like I said, from anywhere from 0 to a maximum of 5 corner pieces that are misoriented. They are in the right locations, but they will need to be reoriented or twisted so that they'll line up with the cube. And if we look at our this study cube, in this case, we just had 2 that were misoriented. The first part of this step is to place them in the same layer. And it's very possible, and in this case this is true, it's very possible that you won't have the white or yellow layer on the bottom. So it doesn't matter which one's on the bottom, as long as the 2 pieces that we're going to be working on, and we'll work on 2 at a time, the 2 need just to be in the bottom layer. So make sure that that's the case. So we line them up down there, and then we're going to use from our introductory video, you remember that the series of 4 coffer swaps would actually reorient 2 of our corner pieces. So we're going to use the series of 4 coffer swaps, and we want to figure out which one to utilize first. Whenever we've got an even number like this, one of them, if we start the coffer swap, notice that it begins to orient correctly. I'm going to turn it back, and I'm going to just study the other one here, the other possibility. And when I rotate it up, notice that it does not start to orient correctly. So I'm going to try to avoid to use the word incorrect or wrong. It's just the alternate way. And by the way, we could reverse this and do a right swap and then a left swap, but I'm going to stick with our standard left side coffer swap for training purposes. So, and if that's the case, this one is orienting correctly. So we're going to call this corner piece over here buddy number 1. And then the one that is twisting up in an alternate direction, we'll call buddy number 2. So we're going to perform a series of swaps on this one. We're going to take it up to the top, bring it back a different direction. Then we're going to substitute in buddy number 2, take it up to the top, bring it back a different direction. And that will reorient both of these pieces in a series of just 4 swaps. So let's start with this one. We'll take it up. And by the way, there's not a true designated flex corner up here. Sometimes it'll be the back right corner. Sometimes it may be the back left corner, depending on if we're swapping on the left or right side. But we really don't have to worry about it as long as we're starting in the correct location down here. It won't matter if one of these is colored or mismatched or not in this particular step. So we're still using a flex corner up here. It's just, again, we're not having to identify it because we're going to be swapping it twice in a row. So it'll reset itself each time. All right, let's begin with this one. We're going to do a coffer swap on the left side. Swap it up. And then I want to bring it back a different direction. So what I want to do, I want to rotate my cube. And I want to do a coffer swap on the right side. It's the same active column. And I'm going to take it up on the right side to bring that corner piece back a different direction. And notice that it reoriented my piece. So where it was misoriented before, it has now fallen into place correctly oriented. The rest of the cube is pretty messed up, but remember, we're doing everything in pairs that will restore balance or harmony to our cube. So we're not done yet. Maintain that left grip so that you don't lose your place, and go ahead and we're going to tee up buddy number 2 into our active corner down here, and we're ready for what we're going to call, we're going to kind of reverse what we did before. We're going to do an encore right swap. I'm going to change hands and grips again, and I'm going to do an encore left swap. And then all I have to do is just realign my cube, and we've completed the Rubik's Cube. Let me show you another example of step 6, the final step in our Rubik's Cube solution. And I'm going to use a worst case scenario here. Remember, I said that we could have anywhere from 0 to a maximum of 5 corners that were misoriented. Everything's in its right location. But what I've done is I've set a cube up that has 5 corners that are misoriented. They're in the right location where they need to be. They're just twisted or an alternate orientation from the final solution. So this is the worst case scenario and will give us our maximum number of swaps that we'll have to do. But we're still going to do kind of a series of 4 swaps. And we'll just need to cycle that through several times to correct these different corner pieces so that they'll be correctly oriented. So what I want to do is I want to begin with, I want to work with two at a time. So I want to find two buddy pieces that are in the same layer. I'm going to start with the bottom layer here, the yellow layer, because it's already got four misoriented sides, so I should be able to find several in this layer to work with. I want to find buddy one, which will actually rotate up correctly. So let's use this piece right here. And then I need to find a buddy two that will orient in a different direction when I start a coffer swap. And there's one just coincidentally I located right there. So I've got this one we'll call buddy two. This one we'll call buddy one. And we'll start with our coffer swaps. Again, this is a step where your grip will be very important, because I'm going to do some left side swaps. And I'm going to change hands and grips and do some right side swaps. I'm going to take this piece up with a left swap. I'm going to change hands and grips. I'm going to bring it back with a right swap, and that will twist it over. And then I'm going to swap my buddy pieces and do the same thing to restore harmony to the cube by completing that set of moves. So let's begin. I'm going to start here with buddy one. Again, I'm not too worried about what this color is up here, or even if it's in that location. This is kind of in our standard location, but it wouldn't matter even if it was in a different location, because we're going to be cycling through that corner no matter what it looks like. And let's start with the buddy one here, the one that starts in a correct orientation direction. I'll do a left coffer swap. I'm going to carefully change hands and grips. I'm going to bring that same piece back with a right side coffer swap. And notice how it has now corrected its orientation. The rest of the cube is kind of messed up because I have to do these moves in sets of paired moves. So what I need to do now is I need to rotate in or tee up buddy number two, which was this corner, get in it in position. I'm going to do, in my first set of moves, I did a left swap and then a right swap. So this time I want to do a right swap and then a left swap to restore the cube again. And let's begin with an encore right swap. Change hands and grips, same active column each time, and I'm going to do an encore left swap. And notice that this one's correctly oriented. It's okay at this point to go ahead and realign the cube. I don't want to do that earlier because it would mess everything up if I was in between my set of paired moves there. So don't reorient the cube until you've finished a complete set. And notice that we corrected two of our corners that were incorrectly oriented, and so we're down to three that are misoriented. And in this case, because it's an odd number, I can't correct two at the same time, because all of these are going to be orienting the same way. They're all orienting correctly. So I can only correct one, but I'll still have to go through the same number of orientation moves just to restore the parity or balance to the cube. So it doesn't matter which two I pick for buddy number one, buddy two, random, as long as they're in the same bottom layer of the cube. I'll start with this one as buddy one, and I'll use this as buddy number two. I'm going to do a left swap. And notice, by the way, there's no defined flex corner up here. I will be cycling it through this corner, but this is a good example of that. It doesn't matter what it looks like up here. I'm just going to use that as a temporary location, and again, it'll cycle back through to restore itself in a moment. So I'm going to do a left swap to take it to the top. I'm going to switch hands and grips. I'm going to return that one with a right swap. So I'm bringing it back in a different direction, and that reoriented it correctly. Cube's pretty messed up. I need to finish out my buddy moves here. I tee up buddy number two to the same active corner. I do an encore right swap. Change hands and grips. Do an encore left swap to bring that piece back. So I brought it back down. It's once again, I've completed that cycle of moves. It's okay to realign my cube. Notice I got one correction because of the odd number we started with. And I have two remaining ones. I put them in the same plane of the cube, and I want them on the bottom face of the cube. Again, it doesn't matter what color's facing down, as long as the two that I'm working on are on the bottom face. I'm going to discover which one is going in the correct direction. It's not that one. Let me study this one. Okay, it looks like this one does begin to orient correctly when I do a test move like that. So this will be buddy one. This will be buddy two. I've got them on the same bottom layer. And I'll do a left swap with buddy one. Change grips and hands. Same active column. Do a right swap to bring it back. Notice how it correctly oriented. I'm going to tee up buddy number two. It was kitty corner, so I did a double turn there. I'm going to maintain that firm grip, so I remember which part of this I'm on. And then I'm going to do an encore right swap. And then I'm going to change hands and grips. I'm going to do an encore left swap. And then I just realign my cube. And we corrected two with that one, so we've completed another Rubik's Cube solution. Now let me demonstrate one other possibility that sometimes can occur. This is a case where we've got three misoriented corners, once again. And remember, we can only correct one at a time when we've got three because of the odd number, but we'll still do the same set of moves to restore harmony to the cube. It doesn't matter which ones we begin with as long as the two we're working on are in the same bottom layer. So I'll make this one buddy number one. I'll make this one buddy number two. And I'll just take this one up, even though it's going the wrong direction, the second one will correct itself. I'll take this one up, do a left swap. I'll change hands and grips, do a right swap. I'll maintain that left grip, that's the secret here. I'll rotate in or tee up buddy number two so that it's ready for our encore swaps. I'll do an encore right coffer swap. Change hands and grips, same active column. I'll do an encore left coffer swap. Now that I've completed that series, it's okay to align the cube. Don't do it before then. It'll mess things up pretty good. And notice that I corrected one because we started with three. Again, an odd number. We can only correct one at a time. But now we're down to just two that are misoriented, two corners that are misoriented. And we can actually correct both of these at the same time as long as we put them in the same bottom layer. But notice that they're diagonally opposite each other. So they're not in the same layer. We've got a bottom layer here, bottom layer here. So what we need to do is bring one of them down to the other matching layer. And what we want to do is we want to bring the alternate one down. So in this case, this particular corner piece, is we're going to call buddy one because it starts to orient the correct way. So I know that this will be buddy number one, and this will be buddy number two, and I just need to bring buddy number two down to our bottom layer. And I want to do that with just one turn so I don't get too confused at the very end here. I can bring it down to the side, I can bring it over this way. I'm just going to go this way because that's natural for me. But now I've got both buddies in the same bottom layer. So I'm going to do my set of turns, my series of four on this one, buddy one, and then I'll do a series of four on buddy number two. So our same procedure we had before. We're going to do a left swap. Just change hands and grips, bring it back with a right swap. Tee up buddy number two, which was kitty corner in this case. So I'm doing a double turn down here. I've got buddy number two teed up, ready to go for an encore right swap. Change hands and grips, same active column, and I'm going to do an encore left swap. Now notice my cube is not quite in alignment, and there should be one row that's got all three colors the same. So if I just line that up with the correct side, I should just be two turns away from completing the cube. So because I had to do that one extra turn in there to bring my buddy two down to the same layer, there's just one extra turn at the end, and I just wanted to demonstrate that one. But we've got another cube solved. Congratulations.